It was scripts and story that I couldn't get out of my head. I found myself thinking about it all the time. And, you know, that led to the moment where I was like, I'd love to pitch on this and join the party, I suppose. I definitely think that, you know, the treatment of this story is hopefully complex and empathetic and respectful to everyone involved. And I think, you know, it's a story about different truths, truths that are, you know, presented to you and inviting you to have an opinion on those truths, and also the truths that you tell yourself, perhaps to get by. And I think in the making of the show, we are honest with you, the audience, about the fact that we also are just storytellers, and this is just a version of the truth. This is just a version of the story. A lot of the visual decisions that were made were to try to get you into the headspace of the characters of Susan and Christopher. And I think, you know, for example, like the way we use red and green, that's kind of like the bodies were found buried in a backyard, and in our show, they're buried under some red and green flowers. And so the colours red and green came to be used in a way that was emblematic of the murder, or symbolic of guilt, if you like, and kind of haunt the more romantic aesthetics that are also at play in the show. So, you know, if you're remembering some beautiful romantic moment of when you were first getting together, Susan being someone who was particularly enamoured with classic Hollywood films and old westerns, it might play in a certain way, and then at another time it might play in a sort of more foreboding, unnerving way, and almost kind of theatrical way, I guess, which hopefully invites the audience to sort of see the same story, the same truths in different ways depending on how it's presented to you.
You're blessed with two of the finest performers in the world, with David and Olivia. Can you talk a little bit about what you think makes them both so very special and what they specifically bring to these performances?
Well, I think both of them are, first of all, just really lovely to work with and lovely human beings. Very generous on set, always prepared. But also I think they're both very versatile and especially good at kind of navigating the line between the light and the dark. I think they're as good at, you know, selling a comedic beat as they are being vulnerable and selling a dramatic moment. And I think they just both bring a real lightness of touch to these characters, a real humanity. And just together as well, I think they really sell this sort of romantic aspect of landscapers. Because I guess it is a true crime drama, but it almost more than that, I think of it as a kind of romantic psychodrama, and it's about the sort of psychology of the fictionalized version of these characters.